Hi everyone! Hope you've had a lovely day at school. I hope you've been really, really good. I'm sure you have. Can't imagine you guys being bad. So, anyway, I've got a bit of sunshine coming through. I don't know what's going on. Yeah, is that better? I don't know. Anyway, there we are. So it's that time of day again. So Nana's going to read you a story. And today is going to be called Dumbo's Parade Pals. So, if you're sitting comfortably, then Nana will begin. When Dumbo's circus came into town, the animals and circus folk marched in a big parade. The crowd loved seeing all the circus animals marching down the street in a big line. Suddenly, Dumbo noticed a peanut on the ground. He picked up the peanut with his trunk and ate it. Then Dumbo saw another peanut and another. Leaving the parade, Dumbo followed the trail of peanuts all the way to the playground around the corner. "See, the peanuts worked," exclaimed a little girl with pigtails. "Now we have our own elephant to play with." "Let's have our own circus," said a boy.
"I'll be ringmaster," cried the little girl.
"Ladies and gentlemen, presenting our star attraction, the little elephant." Dumbo knew just what to do. He stood on his two back legs, then he juggled some balls with his trunk, and the children all cheered. Soon Timothy Q Mouse appeared. "Here you are," he said to Dumbo. "We have to get back to the circus camp to get ready for the show." Dumbo nodded and waved goodbye to his new friends. "I wish I could go to sit with him to the circus tonight," one of the children said, "but I don't have enough money for a ticket." Dumbo was sorry that the nice children he had met would not be able to go to the circus. That night, he felt very blue as he put on his stage makeup and warmed up his ears. Dumbo tucked Timothy into the brim of his hat and sadly climbed onto the tall platform. "Ladies and gentlemen," the ringmaster cried, "I give you Dumbo, the flying elephant." Dumbo leapt off the platform, and his giant ears unfurled. The crowd cheered as Dumbo flew around the tent. Far below in the crowd, Dumbo spotted his playground friends sitting in the first row. He swept by them, patting each child on the head with his trunk. The girl with the pigtails waved at Dumbo. "Your mouse friend gave us free tickets," she cried. Dumbo smiled and reached his trunk up to the brim of his hat where Timothy was riding. He was the luckiest elephant in the world to have such wonderful friends. Oh, that was wonderful, wasn't it? So they managed to go and see him at the circus. How fantastic. That was amazing to watch Dumbo flying around the circus ring. Wow. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. And let's have a look, see what tomorrow brings. Oh, tomorrow's Bambi. Oh, Nana likes Bambi. So we'll look forward to that. So you be good. Have the most amazing night's sleep. And I will see you again tomorrow. So put my book out of the way. So I love you loads and loads. So be really, 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 really good. So I love you, Atty. I love you, Torben. I love you, Ruby. And I love you, Max. You be especially good tonight. And I will see you tomorrow. Love you.